I'm always amazed when you go through the process, when you're editing a show, you put in temp music. So you use cues from other pieces. And, you know, sometimes it works well and sometimes it doesn't. But I'm always amazed once I get your demos and something has been written specifically to the individual scenes, yeah. You know, in the way that we've talked about, how much more it elevates the drama.
For me, one of the things that makes this show a new experience is there are no commercial breaks.
Right.
So there is this... So
is that the first time you've done that?
This is the first time I've done a cable show that doesn't have commercial breaks.
Right. I think basic cable, like Walking Dead, has less commercial breaks than network television.
Yeah.
And I remember when I was doing Flash Forward, they said, okay, well, now we're going to add six commercial breaks. And like six? You're building to this sort of artificial crescendo, like, you know, every 6 minutes. This is the first time I've ever done a show on premium cable where there aren't any commercial breaks. And it's so much more of a relief to not have to deal with that.
Yeah.
And we've all had that experience where something really intense will happen and then you'll literally cut to like, I don't know, like a commercial for a Swiffer or something.
Right,
like
I know.
And you're just like, no! You know, and we don't have to do that here. It's rare in television, in particular, that I'm conscious of score in a good way. There aren't that many composers, you know, working television that I think are doing really memorable stuff. I was introduced to Battlestar Galactica through your score first, and I just took a mental note. I was like, who is this composer guy? He's really good. And then I got a lot of friends who work on Walking Dead, and kind of Bernard Herrmann-like theme at the beginning of Walking Dead is, again, it makes a big impression. And I thought, you know, who's this? And I said, oh, it's the same guy. And I think that those two scores are very dissimilar from one another. So yeah. I thought this is a guy that's got a really wide range. I called you up and said, I got this Da Vinci show. I remember you came into my office. I showed you the first episode and said, what do you think?
I believe I said, I'm in. I mean,
you did.
I was hooked. I mean, I just loved it. I'd never seen anything like it, and especially never had the chance to work on anything like that. And it's just been so great to get into a period piece, but that's also so contemporary. In a weird way, even though I'm doing stuff that is done with Renaissance instruments, this is the most stylized show I've ever worked on.
So here I am at the site of the actual Easter Massacre. 10 days ago, I was scoring a scene that took place in here, and now I'm here. That's crazy. I think for season two, they should let me come in and play the theme on that pipe organ. Just for authenticity's sake.
Do we want to stop there?
Yes, please.
Let's stop there.